I think I suppose the revised national TB control program, which is working for nearly 2 decades, is doing a wonderful job as regards the control of TB in this country, that the program has been able to reduce the mortality, to reduce the prevalence of the disease. Although still the incidence is quite high, we are still having about 23% of the world TB in our country. But it is obviously understood it is because of our large population, and we are having a large reservoir of infected population in the country. Then in addition to this, program is doing its bit, but I suppose the basic thing for the TB to be, you know, to be totally controlled, or I should not use the word eradication, but to have a reasonable control, the best thing I should understand that we should strike at the bottom of the problem. Like say for example, we know that it is a disease of poverty, it is a disease of overcrowding, it is a disease of you know, slum areas, it is a disease of the you know, those having low immunity. So I think the basic thing will be our improvement in the socio-economic standard of this our population in the country, for which a sustained political commitment is required. I think with the current political dispensation, where the Prime Minister and this present government is committed to improve our economic condition, and our country is marching ahead, so I suppose this will be one important contribution towards that, getting good housing, good nutrition, you know, the avoiding overcrowding, improving the immunity, etc., will go a big way. But however, I should tell, even if we achieve these things, the second problem will be, we still will have a very huge you know, TB infected pool in the country. So for the, if you take an average lifespan of the person about 60 years, so maybe for the next 50-60 years, we'll still have a large pool or large reservoir of infected patients in the infected subjects, not patients, infected subjects in the country. So therefore, our the effort of revised national TB control program should be sustained and should be continued. As for the other achievements of the program, I think what the program has achieved, now the treatment, the investigation, everything is given at the doorstep of the patient, free of cost. But the main problem is still a huge chunk of the TB patients, they are not coming into the government fold. They go to the private sector, or they don't report. They must be going somewhere. Somewhere means they go to the private sector. And therefore, our private sector is a big handler of TB cases, and they should be able to contribute to the program in the contribution of TB, for which the program is already working in that direction, like giving them proper training, and then to giving a proper prescription, explaining the patient to complete the course, and then the obviously the private treatment is always costly, because the patient has to pay for that. So then something has to be done to take care of that. And then as regards the other improvements is the diagnostic facilities that the program has developed over the past 3-4 years. We have got many accredited laboratories, near about 64, where the culture facilities are available. And then obviously the microscopes, the microscopic centers, we have got over 13,000. The free drugs, everything has come up very nicely. And then the other important aspect I should tell, that the program is going hand in hand with any new development that has taken up in the TB. Particularly, I like to talk about the newer diagnostic, that the CBNAT and the other diagnostic modalities, the program has very quickly adopted that. The 2 or 3 new drugs that has come up, the program has adopted to that. And then at the end, I should say, program is involving all the stakeholders, like medical colleges. Now 363 medical colleges are part of the program. They are helping the program in devising the various strategies, and then in their advocacy, etc. So, and obviously the civil society, the NGOs, and all these people, then they are part of this program. So these are some of the issues which the program should do, and I should say, and then what are the various difficulties and what, how we should go ahead, go forward. So these are some of my thoughts. You see, the help can be done on one or two. One thing is just making some revelation may not be good enough. So that was initially thought of, but I think that will never work. If you cannot regulate anybody what he should do. But what I suppose can be done, because as we see, as our experience says that not all, many in the private sector, the treatments, the regimens used is not very adequate. They don't insist, they are not bothered, or neither obviously because of obvious reasons. The completion of the therapy or completion of the duration of treatment is never, although they might be telling the patient, but they don't have got a means that they should see that the patient completes the therapy. The private practitioner, the patient, as long as the patient comes to them, they can give you the prescription. But whether the patient is completing that, is purchasing that or not, that they cannot ensure. So therefore, I think so what can be done, there should be partnership between the program and the private practitioners. I think for that reason, it already, the pilot testing is already being done at 3-4 places. So that means if a private practitioner is giving a reasonable prescription or the acceptable prescription, the patient, instead of purchasing the drug himself and spending the money, he goes to the chemist, and then the chemist gives the drug free of cost, and then that drug cost is being reimbursed by the program or the government. So that way the private practitioner is happy, and then the cases, they are getting a good reasonable prescription, and the patient is getting free treatment. So his, you know, his compliance, the treatment will be very good. So I think this is a very good model, and one should think and work more on this. Apart from their regular, teaching, their CME, updating their knowledge, this has to continue. Same. TB case notification is a very, very, that was hardly any, that was before few years, then it was decided. So now actually TB is a notifiable disease by law. It has to, if you are seeing a case of TB, you have to report it to the system or to the government. But still many people are not reporting. So for that, the government, the program has taken many initiatives, like medical colleges. You see 20% of the cases, all TB cases in the country, they are reported by the medical colleges. Now even the private sector, since this partnership has developed, I think about more than 3 lakhs cases have been reported by the private practitioners to the program. Similarly, in the private laboratories, they are also reporting the cases, and any private practitioners, the private hospitals, corporate hospitals, they are also reporting to the program, I should say. So this is a very good improvement, this is a very welcome step. I should say this program, the strategy, and what we are doing, that is obviously in thought and in principle, they are very good. So what I suppose we should do, that is as a society and as a civil society, as a government, as anybody of this country, and including the program, that we should see that it is properly implemented. Whatever we are deciding that, okay, then it has to be implemented in total. It cannot be part and parcel of it. We do something, we decide a program, we took a decision, but there is no money. We have got the money, but then it is not being transmitted to the periphery. So I think this type of thing should be avoided, but otherwise we have got very good strategy, and I hope we will be able to meet the 2035 NTB strategy.